Jeremy, so we're going to go to the third scene that we chose in You Are Up. What's the scene?
This is my favorite scene of the movie, and this is the scene when they're in the goat barn.
The goat barn scenes. In these scenes, Grace finally escapes from her house, and...
So I ran to the end of the road, and when I got there, I thought maybe I'd run to the end of town.
President Carter, suffering from heat exhaustion, fell into the arms
of... When I got there, I thought maybe I'd just run across Greenbow County. And I figured since I run this far, maybe I'd just run across the great state of Alabama.
And so you just ran.
Yeah.
Grace hides behind a tree when she sees a flashlight searching for her. She finds her way to the goat barn, rushing to hide from the following flashlights. As the light gets closer, it is revealed that it was Georgie who was seeking her. With a sigh of relief, she approaches Georgie to summarize the situation.
Stop! Hammer time!
As Georgie blows a golf ball-sized hole into Grace's hand, stunned from the shot, anger slowly coursing through her body, she realizes what happens. She rears back and... She picks up the flashlight, surprised by a goat, stumbles back and falls through the locked hatch doors. Catching her breath from the fall, she's sucking the rancid air from the decomposing flesh around her.
Don't hurl, because if you hurl and I catch a whiff of it, man, I'm going to spew. And if I blow chunks, chances are someone else is going to honk, all right?
Regaining her composure, she begins to realize all the rotting dead that is around her. Grace sees a ladder, then slowly begins her climb. She struggles to get up the rungs, and in her final push to get out of the pit, she puts her hand through a nail. Getting over the agony of the pain, she tears the sleeve and wraps it around her hand to help aid in the bleeding. She angrily calls Georgie,
"You little fucker!"
as he's still unconscious.
Why'd you choose this scene, man?
It came out of nowhere! This is the only thing that caught me by surprise.
Surprise, motherfucker.
I think this was the do or die moment for Grace. Of where was Grace's decision? Was she going to really take this game seriously or not? Now, I know you could say, like, people could argue, like, yeah, she could have took it seriously beforehand and stuff, and she was frightened. But here, I think it was the moment where, like, I think reality hit. Because she hasn't been really hurt per se until this scene.
I think why I enjoyed this scene so much, because A, we get to see how effed up this family is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you already didn't know that this family was pretty effed up just in general, like seeing kids get involved, you're just kind of like, okay, this is pretty effed up. But the fact that she does a humongous haymaker... to the kid can only make Czerny, our old friend, very happy.
You got knocked the fuck out.
I think it's true. Like, for her, like, you would let your guard down when it comes to a kid. And for him to shoot a hole into your hand, yeah. No holes barred, man. Once rules fell, I co-cocked that kid too as well.
Yeah.
And I'd feel super satisfied about this.
Yeah. And then just the fact that her struggle of trying to get out of the barn in general, that whole particular spot, was a great scene to me, because the fact that what she has to do to survive, that was her at her dirtiest and almost her bloodiest at that point. And so, and I think that just triggered for me. And that's why I think, like I said, I think I connect with Grace in this movie, because I would feel the same way. Yeah, Cole caught that kid. I got shot in the hand. Yeah, it's still a shock. You're still in shock because you haven't been shot yet.
Yeah.
It's a reality, you know? And the fact that from there, going through the struggle, and you're walking out just looking worse and worse and worse. And I always enjoy movies where, like, when you're in a world like that, there's no way you can come out of this clean. So I like it because it shows the struggle. Like, she is going through the struggle from the beginning. You can even tell by her dress of how much struggle she's going through. Yeah, so I really like that scene. I really did. I really did. So.
Yeah, no, I thought this is partly where the movie started slowly getting good. And I think this is probably where it started turning into more of a... You started seeing a little bit more action.
Mm-hmm.
And that was kind of the enjoyable part. Then also seeing that, yeah, there is no bounds to this family and there is no boundaries. Like, they're gonna do everything that they do. And then seeing the, I guess, the pit of dead goats, and also the guy that was killed at the very beginning of the movie, who had the two arrows shot into him.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't put two and two together until that, I think, that scene where I didn't realize that the crazy aunt, like, that was her husband. That was the person that she was initially married to.
Mm-hmm.
And everything that went on to that and where it became kind of crazy, and that this family's different.
Mm-hmm.
And then just seeing, I think, the interaction, because we'll continue on with the barn scene, not only from this, but also whenever, like, Daniel and the sister go into the barn scene, and they have that conversation where it's like, is this real? Is this not real? I mean, do you really believe that, you know, if we don't kill her, then all of us are going to die? Like, that sounds ridiculous, right?
Mm-hmm.
As well as the, I think that was where you kind of slowly started seeing whether or not Daniel was going to turn to actually care more about the family, I think. Because throughout this entire first half of the movie, he was just kind of like, this is stupid. I really don't want to be a part of this. To listening to the sister, which the sister, I think, also came off at the very beginning of the movie as, I thought she was going to be more on Grace's side, but then she kind of didn't. I mean, obviously she didn't, because she was the first one. Grace was the one that killed Claire,
mm-hmm.
Which I forgot to mention in the very beginning. But I mean, Grace was the one that, or I mean, she, not Grace, I'm sorry. The sister was the one that killed Claire. I think that when she said that, you know, my kids don't deserve to die.
We all deserve to die.
My kids don't.
Is when you started seeing Daniel like, yeah, you're right. You know, I'm going to struggle. He's got that internal struggle, whether or not he really needs to help the family or not. Because I think that's the biggest thing about this is, like, whether or not that whole thing is true. If they don't kill the bride, are they all just going to randomly die somehow? And I think that was the big push and the big thing about this movie. Like, everything led to the point where, is it or is it not true? And I think that was the struggle you got to see with Daniel there. It was like, whether or not it's like, even if it's a believable hint of truth, if it's even a small hint of truth, he thought the kids don't deserve to die. But he's also thinking to himself, like, kids are kind of effed up too, because they actually shot, you know, Grace. He was kind of like, why did you do that? It's like, well, because everyone else is trying to kill her.
I followed that lady down here and I shot her with that gun I found.
Why would you do that?
That's what everyone else was trying to do.
Just following suit. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right. Like, I don't know if he just kind of looked at it and just started wondering, is like, should this be the norm? Like, I don't know what the deal is, but I felt that's how I felt about the movie, or yeah, how I felt about that scene.
I think also, too, is just the fact of, like, it kind of shows that it kind of gives you that mindset of how many times they have done this and how much is wearing some of these people out, at least some of them. You know, like, we've been doing this for so long. Like, is it really true? Is it really, really true? Or are we doing this because we just think it's fun, or dad's just gone as nuts, and why are we not going against him or anything like that? And for the sister, I still have that mindset, like, she's still kind of coked up. So, like, anything she says is just like, I don't want my kids to die. I was like, yeah, but you're still kind of coked up right now, so I don't know where your head is really at right now. Because she, at the same time, she congrats Georgie for shooting her. Good boy. So I was like, okay. Meanwhile, by the way, the other kid is still asleep, hasn't done nothing in this, nothing yet, right?
Right.
So
yeah, the other kid was just still chilling and sleeping. Yeah, running. It's, yeah, crazy. I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, like, this kid's still asleep while all this is going on. So he's a head sleeper, or he's just a good kid. So
just chilling in his own room, just minding his own business.
I guess goats are the best choice to eat up bodies.
No, I mean, they didn't eat up the body. The body just rot. Like,
oh, okay.
The ant's husband, or you know, Aunt Helen's dead husband was just there with two arrows in the chest, and then he looked like he rotted, but. I'm going to be honest with you, for like, they look older. Like, they look like 40 years older than what they were when they first came into the movie, at the very beginning of the movie. Mm-hmm. Like, in 40 years, I'd imagine that the body would have decomposed a little bit more than that. But that's where they throw dead bodies and goats.
I think also in this scene, I asked myself, if I got shot by the kid, and after knocking him out and dealing with the situation in the goat pit and everything like that, would that question me to give up? I mean, that's a lot of shit happening all at once, right? And a question in my head would be like, is it time to give up, or is this the best hiding place till the game is over? Yeah,
like, why not hide in the goat pit, right? until whenever, right?
Yeah, I mean, it smells a little bad. I get it. But they were not. But what was their reason to go out there other than throw the body up in there? That's the only reason.
They threw the ant. Yeah, besides throwing the ant's bodies.
That's it.
I'm going to be honest with you. I would have thrown Georgie's body in there. F that kid. He shot a hole in my hand. Dude, that hole was like this big.
I know. That's a big. That gun didn't look like it could do that much impact, but it did. So. But that's the question, too. Like, are you talking about knocking out the kid or killing the kid?
No, I would just, I mean, you already co-cocked the kid, knocked him out. You might as well just throw him in there.
Yeah, but would you go in there too? Or would you just throw him in there and move on?
I mean, if I got out, I would just throw him back in there.
I agree with that.
If I got out, I would throw him in there, because at that point, I think at the very least, you would distract at least one or two people.
Right.
For a long period of time to try to get the kid out, right?
Also, on top of that, think about this. They wouldn't even know the kid was out. Only the maid knew.
This only the dead maids, right? Yeah. We must.
Yeah, only the maid knew. No one in the house knew about this kid. Yeah. So if she threw him in the pit, no one would even know. I knew.